Friday here at WKRG, and that means the doctor is in. We're joined by two doctors today, Dr. Reece Jones, who is an oncologist with Southern Cancer Center, and Dr. Adam Huddleston, who is a radiation oncologist with the Gulf Coast Cancer Center. Gentlemen, thanks for being with us today.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
We're talking about lung cancer. Next month is Lung Cancer Awareness Month, so we're kind of getting a jump on that subject, and it's one that is so important to talk about because, Dr. Jones, this is the number one cancer killer.
Yeah, lung cancer is still a devastating disease. Luckily, there's been a new data out now that screening actually has a positive benefit. CAT scan screenings once a year for heavy or former smokers has led to an improvement in survival, the first screening test in a long time.
Wow. And so is that something that insurance would actually pay for to go have a preventative CAT scan?
It is paid for now. If you have over a 30-pack year smoking history between the ages of 55 and 75, and you've still your current smoker or quit smoking within the last 15 years, insurance will pay for it.
Wow. So well, you know, a lot of people think, can you go get a chest x-ray and that would detect lung cancer, but oftentimes it doesn't,
at least in the early stages. Obviously, if you have symptoms, you present to a doctor, one of the early tests you'll get is a chest x-ray. If there's any abnormalities, that of course would be followed up with a CT, which is definitely a better test.
Okay, now there have been so many advancements in lung cancer treatment through the years, and one of those areas is in radiation. So talk a little bit about how you can really target the cancer cells in the lungs and help people live longer.
It's true, and it sort of goes hand in hand with early detection with screening CT scans. When we find these cancers at an early stage, we can use very precise, targeted, high-dose radiation with excellent long-term responses and really minimal toxicity. It's really a really, very nice way to treat these folks who otherwise, you know, may not be good candidates for surgery or other types of therapies.
So they may not be good candidates for surgery because their tumor might be too large?
That and their overall general health may be poor and putting them at very high risk for a surgical procedure.
And one area that's become very exciting, you used the word exciting earlier when we were talking about lung cancer treatments, is in immunotherapy.
Yes.
So what exactly is that? You've seen the commercials on TV for these really miraculous sounding drugs.
Right. Immune therapy is approved now in only metastatic disease, which unfortunately still over half of lung cancers are diagnosed at stage four. Cancer is smart enough to basically apply a brake mechanism to the body's own immune system. These drugs allow a release of that brake mechanism and allows your body's own immune system to attack the cancer. And it's specific enough against just the cancer and usually does not have much in the way of side effects for the rest of the body.
Wow, so that's going hand in hand with radiation, chemotherapy. You're using these good cells
right
to fight the cancer.
Yeah, and we're able to give a treatment that has minimal, if any, side effects.
Right.
You know, cytotoxic chemotherapy still has its place and oftentimes is given in conjunction with immune therapy. But to be able to give a drug that improves survival significantly with very few side effects is one of the biggest advancements in oncology we've had in a long time.
Well, absolutely. There's so much to talk about in terms of lung cancer treatment. And we want you to ask your questions to Drs. Jones and Huddleston. They're going to be joining us on Facebook Live as we talk about lung cancer. They will be with us at 12:30. So be sure to log on to WKRG's Facebook page and we'll see you then.
Thank you.
Thank you.